Thank you for joining me on Global Conference TV. You are watching Inspired Conversations, Leaving the Legacy with Legends. Joining me today is a man that is after the hearts of people. Mngoma is a mentor, coach, and a trainer. Mr. Mzi, welcome to the show, sir, and you are welcome.
Mdala, thank you very much. Thank you very much for having me.
Let's just start from the beginning.
Yes, sir.
Kimang that Mngoma.
Mngoma, he's a young man of 43.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, he's a father of three, he's a husband of one wife. And of course, he comes from Soweto. I was born and bred in Soweto.
Okay.
I'm a Sowetan. I love inspiring people, and I love life. I enjoy life. So Mngoma is someone who happens to be in a space where he feels that every human being has got a potential, every human being has got a problem to solve. So that's what I'm all about. I'm encouraging people, I'm provoking people, you know, for them to be able to solve a particular problem.
And I believe that's where Mngoma Empowerment Group started.
Absolutely.
Can Mngoma you share a little bit?
Yes. Yeah. No, we did. Yeah. Well, it comes from that background, leadership, where as Mngoma Empowerment Group, we want to do nothing else but want to bring out the best in people. And then for the past 4 years, we've been doing that. And we keep on doing that in making sure that every person that is listening to us right now, you know, brings out the best in themselves.
And what are the services that you actually do in,
yeah,
in your company?
Well, that's very interesting, because one thing that we're doing few things, but at the primary level, we're doing training and skills development.
Okay.
That's what we do. We train your SMMEs, we're training business leaders, we're training church leaders, we're training organizational leaders, your NPO leaders, your cooperative leaders. We're training them so that they can be able to run their organizations with power and with influence and with impact. That's what we do. But over and above that, we also are registering businesses. For example, if you want to register your church, your SMME, your business, and you want to register anything under the sun that needs to be registered, we're doing that.
Right.
And then, but it falls within the ambit that we call enterprise development.
Okay.
Because that's what we do. In us bringing out the best, we believe that you need to register and own something that has your name on it.
Talking about registering,
yes,
you know, I have just came around a lot of people,
yeah,
who are running businesses without registering them.
Yeah.
And when you ask them, okay, why don't you register your business?
Yes.
They'll say, no, I'm afraid to pay tax. You know, another lady actually said to me,
sure,
I'm afraid to register my business because they will cancel my grant.
Yeah.
You know, so what is actually important of registering a business?
It is very interesting. It's so amazing that even yesterday I was asked the same question, to say why it is important. There are many reasons why it is important for you to register your business. But number one, we're talking credibility. You cannot be regarded as a credible business until it is registered. Now, it talks to your credibility. Number two, it talks to your professionalism. You can't be taken seriously if you've got a business that is not registered.
Okay.
Number three, you've got customers, you've got clients that wants to connect with you, you've got partners, people that want to partner with you. Now, how can they do that until you've got a legal entity called a business?
Yeah.
So now you definitely will need to do that. And also for tax purposes as well, for you to be recognized as one of the taxpayers, indeed, you need to register. Not because you want to pay tax or you don't want to pay tax,
yeah,
but it is very critical for you to do that.
No, that's powerful.
Absolutely.
Now, after you guys help them to register their business,
yes,
is there any way where you help them to maybe running the business, just making sure that the business is running? Because if you look at the statistics,
mm-hmm,
they have shown that many businesses are registered,
yeah,
but many of them, they don't actually even finish a year, you know,
yeah,
then after that they are nowhere to be found.
That is true.
So do you guys help them actually to make sure that the business is running,
yeah,
after they register their business?
Yeah.
Is there any way that you help them?
Yeah. We do that. We do that leadership so much. But what we do, we don't do the hit and run, like, you know, some few of the organizations, because what they do, they come and register people, then of course they give them the certificate, then they close that chapter. With us, we take you by your hand. we register it, and there's a compulsory 3-hour session that we normally have where we sit you down and say, now that your organization is registered, then these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things that you need to do in order for you to become a success. So we mentor you, we coach you in terms of how you can position yourself for success now that you have registered this new entity. That's why a lot of people are coming to us and say, look, Mzi, you did not only register me, but you have also given me the platform, you know, to also connect with other businesses out there as well, because we have created a platform where people can network and talk and share ideas among themselves. And now that's what we do best. No, as the company,
I think that's what actually we need. What we need. But apart from that, you also spoke about NPOs.
Yes.
You know, and we know that there has been stories that many NPOs have been closed because of corruption, because many of them opened them because of they wanted to enrich themselves. So how do you guys actually make sure that if someone wants to open an NPO, he has some good motives about that? How do you make sure, how do you know that this one is the right person to actually open an NPO?
It becomes difficult for us, for us to determine whether this person has got good motives or not. Because people come to us and say, Mzi, I have been referred by this particular church or by this particular business person or by this particular organization because you have done so well in terms of getting, you know, a success of their organization. Now we want you to assist us. Now at that level, it's very difficult for us to know the proper intentions of the person who wants to open that NGO. So it's definitely is difficult in that regard. However, we do have some few questions that we normally ask to say, why do you want to open the organization? What is your overall vision of your organization? And indeed, what is the overall mission that you want to accomplish? What are your vision, if you do have? Then, because we can tell from the response that the person has got good intention, because others will say, look, we want to do it just because we want to solicit funds from the government or from whoever that is a funder. But now the good intentions from giving the response, then that's where we can be able to say, hey man, this is, how about you having this particular idea, and how about you going it this particular way? So we just put some suggestions, but it's very difficult to tell because someone can say something else and yet they act differently.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
In the same note, speaking about NPOs and businesses, helping them to register them, you spoke about funding.
Yes.
And you also helped, you know, the NPOs and then small businesses to get funding. But the question is, who get funding? Because other people came out and said, you know, I applied for funding, I never got it. The only thing that I saw is that my idea was used by someone else. So how do you actually go about helping people to get funding?
We are not funders. However, we help organizations to position themselves so well that they can be able to attract funders. Now we give them, you know, workshops. We workshop them, we give them seminars, we give them, you know, training sessions where organizations, especially the ones that have registered by us and others, or, you know, who are developing interest, for them to be able, you know, to solicit some funds. But there are many reasons why people are not getting funds. Leadership, you know, one of the biggest problems that we always highlight in our workshops is this: people are not properly compliant. All right, now they don't have proper documentation. Someone is listening right now. Someone is watching this beautiful show, this interview, and can you believe, Murutihori, they have had opportunities where they applied and their applications were rejected. And you discover that it is just a tiny little piece of paper where, as a company, we specialize in that. We are saying, please give us your papers. Let us locate your papers. The fact that you've got a certificate that you acquired 5 years, 3 years ago, and it does not guarantee that you're still registered. So those are some of the few things, fundamentals, that we locate and say, The reason why you are not getting funding is because, number one, you are not compliant, meaning you don't have the right documentation for you to be able to solicit these funds. Number two, your proposal is not proper, all right? So you don't know how to properly structure yourself in terms of the documents that you need to submit to the potential funders. So you do not. Another third thing is the kind of leadership that you have and the impact that you are having. For example, funders want to see what you have done in the past. They can't just fund someone that they don't know. So you need to have built up a reputation, a profile for your organization, for you to solicit some funds. So a lot of people, they just want funding, and they don't even properly know how much they want. They don't even know, right? Because that's one thing that we ask in our workshops. That is why they are always being attended by so many people, because they keep on asking to say, why are we sending a proposals and yet they are being rejected? Exactly. So in our workshops, those are some of the few things that we talk about, and many more that we talk about, to say these are the mistakes that you always do in terms of putting a proposal together, in terms of, you know, properly profiling yourself, all right, in terms of pitching yourself, your ideas to the potential funders.
Because I also believe that one of the challenges that actually people have, they don't have actually business plan.
I think
that's one of the challenges that actually people don't have. How can you pitch without a business plan? Because I believe that the funders will actually need your business plan. But apart from that, let's say you were short with a certain document and you are rejected, your application is rejected. Now what happens when you see your idea being used by someone else? What do you do to actually redeem yourself from that?
And I think it becomes difficult really to control the kind of information that goes out from your organization into a third party or a fourth party. You can't control that unless maybe your idea is protected somehow. But very often we go and pitch our ideas and someone else will steal ideas. So ideas are being stolen on a daily basis. And often the case, there's not much that we can do in terms of controlling that. All that matters to us is your ideas somehow will be stolen. And unfortunately, it is one of those realities that, you know, you need to live with. But there are some of those serious matters where you can even take a challenge, especially from your side, when you've got proof that indeed this idea comes from me. And before I came and pitched this idea, you did not. So you need to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that indeed you are the originator of that powerful idea.
No, Mr. Mzi, I hear you, and I believe that you guys are doing a very good job.
Thank you, sir.
People need this kind of information.
Thanks, Mike.
But I want to understand when it comes to, you know, you also mentioned that you have meetings where you invite people to come and share their stories,
and
inspirational stories.
Absolutely.
How has it been?
Man, it's wonderful. You know, listening to someone else's story of moving from zero to be a hero, so to speak, and the people who have gone through suffering and yet they did not kill themselves, they did not take a gun and shoot themselves and their kids and so forth. And you find people who have gone through, you know, the darkness, and now after that darkness, then the light comes on. Those are inspiring stories. In fact, that's what keeps us going. And now that's why we've got platforms such as the workshops, the expos, like the one that we've just had recently, where people were sharing their stories. I mean, there's a story of one gentleman, Alon Pilusa. He's running a powerful radio station. And guess what? I mean, this is the guy who used to travel by foot, you know, from his place. He was born in Soweto. Now he's working in Carltonville. So his story is inspiring in that he was struggling so well. He was struggling so badly, trying to locate, you know, sources of funding to fund his idea. But unfortunately, you know, no help was coming along, but he did not give up. So these are the stories of people who are not giving up. I've got a story of advocate Stoki Mthombeni, for instance. I mean, Stoki Mthombeni, she did something amazing. I mean, she's been a teacher for 28 years. Now, after 28 years, she decided and said, look, Grant, this is not where I'm supposed to be. And now, my dream has always been, I wanted to become an advocate. Now, at the age of 42, then what happens? She studied, you know, for the next 6 years, you know, just before 50, she qualified to become an attorney. So those are some of the inspiring stories, Laura Makafula, and many other stories. So those are powerful stories that inspire the nation, and to say, don't give up. There's so much that has been invested in you. So this is not the time to give up.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Time to move on.
Yes, sir.
You know, I feel you are doing a lot, Mr. Mzi.
Thank you, sir.
Do you have a team that you work with?
Yes, we do. We do, Baba. Yeah, we're not working alone. We've got a team from Mngoma Empowerment Group that we're working with, but we also have associates. You know, we love people, so we've got a lot of associates and the people who come and that we work together. We've got strategic partnerships that we have. So indeed, we do have great men and women out there who are a source of inspiration to all of us.
Mr. Mzi, if people want to get hold of you, you know, to get this wonderful information, this life-changing information,
yes, sir.
Where can they find you?
Absolutely. It's very simple on us because people, you can just Google Mzi Mngoma, M-Z-I Mngoma, then you can get everything that I do. That's number one. But number two, in terms of our company, you can go to Mngoma Empowerment Group, all right, on Facebook, or you can just type Mngoma Empowerment Group, so a lot will come out as far as what we do is concerned. We are also on Facebook, we are also on Twitter, and then now we are on social media, so we do that. But my personal telephone number will be 072-931-0763. I can repeat it, 072-931-0763. Now, if that is the number that you can call me directly, then I can give you everything that you ever wanted to know about ourselves.
Mr. Mzi, thank you very much for coming. But before we close,
yes, sir.
As I've said that, you know, you do a lot of things.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm just asking myself, and one of the things that you actually deal with is time management that you coach with.
Yeah.
And I've met people asking me, you know, personally, I mean, where do you get time? You write books, you speak. Mm. Where do you get time? You know, can I ask you, as you are a time management coach, how do you balance time when you do such a lot of things?
Yeah. There's something that I learned earlier in life, and especially from Stephen R. Covey. He wrote a powerful book called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Now, therein, he also speaks about, especially when he talks about time management, he says there are things which are important, but they are not urgent. So a lot of us are chasing after things which are not urgent and they are not important. So that's why we miss out the issue of valuing time. We all have been given 24 hours.
Exactly.
But now you find one person being so successful, and when you look into what they are doing, they're doing a number of things, They're running the family people, and they are running churches, they're running businesses, they're board of directors in various, but it goes on to show how much of the time and how much of the priorities you give to yourself. But the most critical one of them all is, have you identified your purpose? Because once your purpose has been clearly defined by you, all right, it becomes easier than to say, this is what I prioritize, this is what is important to me. So, but it goes on to show how much of the time we waste because we are pushing things that we are not supposed to push.
Yeah.
But the big question that we always ask in our company is, what problems are you trying to solve? Because a lot of us are solving wrong problems, the problems that are not supposed to solve. So once you know what problems you are solving, then chances are you will be able to know then how to manage time. And then you will know how to put your energies into those things that assist you in terms of fulfilling your purpose and releasing your potential.
That is power, Mr. Mzi.
Sir.
You know, you remind me, my mentor, he usually say, don't be all over the show, but there is nothing to show.
Yeah, that's powerful. I love it.
So thank you very much, Mr. Mzi.
Wow.
We are really blessed. We are really encouraged, motivated, and inspired.
Wow.
And I believe that you will continue doing the good job and then changing lives of people.
Wow.
God bless you and then continue doing the good
job. Dante, thank you so much. And thank you so much for the viewers. And thank you so much for this beautiful interview. And Dante, I was also inspired and I'm still going to continue to inspire others.
Thank you very
and
much.
And thank you for the opportunity, sir.
You're welcome, sir.
Awesome.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching Inspired Conversations, Living the Legacy with Legends, the show that changes lives, the show that motivates, encourages, and inspires. My name is Unkarabile Wisdom Mokoto, and I'm saying to you, the journey continues. Yeah.